Hey, what's up everybody? My name is D and welcome to Smart and Good Channels. And today in this video, I want to share with you guys my newly built dropship website templates. As you can see right here, I have a very nice website design for those who want to start an e-commerce business. The best thing about this website is that you can dropship different products and have your suppliers deliver it to your customers when you make a sale. One of the best things about dropshipping is that you can work literally anywhere on the world with just a laptop and an internet connection. You can start selling different products. This is perfect if you don't have a lot of money to invest because you only pay for the products when you make a sale. So if you watch this video until the end, I will show you exactly how to create this website just like this. I will show you guys how to install the websites, how to customize the websites, how to add products from AliExpress to the website, as well as configure the website so you can get paid when the product is sold. Okay, let's get started. To install this website is very simple. All you have to do is just go to smartandgood.com. Once you are here, click on theme library. Okay, here you can check out all of these available templates. And if you scroll all the way down, you'll see all of my latest build. And we can click right here to view this template. Okay, we can click over here to view it on a different screen size. And if you like this template right here, you can click right here to use this template. We can get started for just $10 a month, but if you want the premium plans where you can get the premium domain name, hosting, SSL certificates, and all of the premium themes and plugins, you can choose this plan right here. But if you already have a domain name, you can click this one right here. Okay, so I'm going to choose this one. Now we can enter the site title and the URL for our website. As you can see, this is our basic domain name. Continue to the next step. Now, if you choose the premium plan, you will have the options of picking the custom domain name. So these are all of these custom domain name that's already taken, but if you make a changes like 101, for example, then it will show you different available domain names. You can click right here to continue to the next step, but because this is an example, so I'm going to skip this step. Now all you have to do is just create an account. Okay, now if you have a coupon, you can enter right here. But if you don't, you can click right here to agree with the terms of services and then create an account. Okay, now log in with the credential we just created. Okay, to activate the websites, we need to check out with Stripe Secure Payment Gateway. Once you are over here, you can enter your card's information, name on the cards, billing address, and then hit subscribe. Okay, so after you check out with Stripe Secure Payment Gateway, you will get redirected to your website's dashboard. Once you are over here, you can now go over here to check out the front end to make sure everything works properly. Okay, you guys, to make the changes for the front end of the websites, it's very simple. If you want to make the changes for the headers and the footers, you can click right here to customize the websites. But if you want to make the changes for the big sections, we can use the Elementor's page builder. We can click right here to go to Elementor's editors. And once you are over here, we can click right here to edit this whole sections. And if you want to change the backgrounds videos, you can click on the styles right here. And as you can see, this is the URL from YouTube. You can copy a new YouTube videos and you can paste this right here. Okay, so this is the background fallback. So if for any reasons the video doesn't load, it will show this image right here. Okay, we can go over here and write something to welcome our visitors. And we can click on these items right here. We can go over to here and click on the custom URL, and then we can paste our links right here. Or if you have a new image, you can click right here, go to your library and pick out your image, or you can upload it from your computer. And you can click right here to insert the media. And it's the same thing for these items over here. We can click right here and we can edit the links. We can edit the text for this button right here. And if you want to make the changes for this image right here, we can click on it. Let me show you guys how to create the image and remove the background. Easy. All you have to do is just go to canva.com. Once you are over here, you can start creating a design right here. We can choose a different size. So to make a design for this image right here, we can save this image right here. And we can find out the dimensions of this image by simply go over here and we can get the info. When you find out the size, we can go back to Canvas and enter the size to create a new design. Okay, we can go to the elements over here. We can search for sneakers, enter. And let's say if you like this image right here, we can just click on it. And we can rotate it a little bit. All right, so to edit this image, we can click right here to edit the image and we can remove the background right here. All right, you guys, and just like that, we can remove the background for this image right here. So it's look very nice. And you can get started with Canva for free. But if you want all of the premium features, you can sign up for the pro plan. As you can see, I have the pro versions right here. And I think it's only $12 a month, so it's a very good deal. I put my affiliates in the video description, so if you decide to use the pro versions, please use my link. Thank you so much. Now we can click right here to download the image. And we can use the transparent background. And then we can hit download right here. Now we can go back to our websites over here. And as you can see, it's downloading right now. And we can go back to Elementor's editor's image. And we can click right here to insert the media. And just like that, we can upload a new image for our websites. And if you scroll down, we can create categories for these sections right here. So if you want to create the categories, we can go to the dashboards over here. We can go to the products category. We can click right here. And let's say I go back to see how many categories we want to create. So one for running, one for women, one for men, and one for the hot products. So total of four. Since I already have the men right here, we can just create for women. Add category. And we can add a running one. And if you scroll down, you see the thumbnail. We can click right here to upload an image. And we can scroll down to find the image we want to upload. And we can choose this one right here. Use it. And we can click right here to add a new category. Okay, now we can view these categories right here. Simply click right here to view it. Now we can go over here. And we can click on this link right here and copy it. Go back to Elementor's editors. We can just click on this button right here and we can paste in the link. Okay, once you're done, you can click right here to update. And we can click right here to preview the changes. Okay, now so when people click on this button right here, it'll take them to the new categories that we just created. Okay, so let me show you guys how to add the products from AliExpress to our websites. First, we need to go to the dashboard. Once you are over here, you can scroll down and go to AliExpress setting. Now we need to add the Ali2Woo Dropships Chrome extensions. We can click right here to add the Chrome extensions. As you can see, I already added, so we can go back over here and we can click on the API key right here and we can add API key. Once you have the API key, we can click right here to copy it. Now we can go back to the Chrome extension. We can right click on it and we can click on the option. Now we can paste in the API key right here and add the store. and we can click right here to authenticate. And just like that, it's authenticated successfully. Now we can go back to our website. And if you go to the pricing rule over here, we can enter a numbers where the product's cost is going to multiply. So it's going to be our product's price. We can click right here to go to the comment settings. As you can see, I already have this item purchase code right here. So this plugin right here is a premium plugin where you can get it from Code Canyon. I believe it's $60 or something like that. But when you sign up for our website, woocommerce.com, you can get this plugin for free. So down here are some of the import settings that you can go over here and make the changes for. For example, so I'm not going to import any images into my descriptions right here. And if you scroll down, there are some of the schedule settings right here, some of the Chrome settings right here. When you're done, you can click right here to save the settings. And if you scroll up and we go to the review settings, we can actually import review from AliExpress products into our website. We can click right here to import products review right here. We can go over here and choose only the 4 to 5 stars review to import it into our website. And we only import 2 to 5 reviews per product. And we can even import the review images right here. When you're done, you can click right here to save settings. Now, if you go to AliExpress.com, you can start looking for the products you want to import to your website. Okay, so if you want to import this product right here, you can simply click on it. And once you are over here, you can check out the shipping. Okay, so it's going to cost us about $10 to ship and $12 to buy this shoes right here. And they have different sizes, different colors. So it's going to cost us about 20 something dollars to sell this product right here. Okay, to import this product, we can click right here to import. We can click right here to open the imports list. And once you are over here, you can start making the changes for these products right here. Let's scroll down to find the one we just added. As you can see, we can make the changes for the titles. We can choose a category. We can enter tags for these products right here. We can go to the descriptions. If you don't want to import the images to your description, you can go to the images right here. And if you scroll down, there will be a box right here where you can just click or unclick to choose the descriptions images. And over here are our variation. So this is the colors, this is the size. So this is how much it's going to cost us, and this is the shipping cost right here. And this price is the price we are selling. So this product costs us about $20 and we are selling it for $35. So this is the profit for this product right here. And as you can see over here is our inventory. We can now go over here, we can set a new value, and we can set it into 4, for example, to make it realistic. And if you scroll down, we can click or unclick to choose this variation. And over here is our specs. We can go over here to make the changes. For example, it's going to be smart and good. All right, now we can push this product to our shop. We can go back to the front end of the website. And if you scroll down, you will see it's right here. We can click on it to view this product. So this website right here is very responsive. If you change the screen size, it will respond accordingly. And this is the view on mobile screen. So it looks very nice. People will have the options of choose the colors, choose the shoe size. As you can see over here, we have the sections where we can write some of our policies down here. And people can click right here to choose the color. They can choose the size. All right. And they can click right here to add the products. Here they can enter the coupon code. And down here is the cart total. We can proceed to checkout. The user will enter the billing details. And over here they can enter their cart information. And then they can check out with your website. Okay, we can click right here to place the order. All right, you guys, and just like that, they can purchase the products from your website. And let me show you how to set up the payment so you can get paid when your product is sold, and how to fulfill this orders right here. So all you have to do is just go back to the dashboard, and you can go to the WooCommerce settings. Over here, you can change your store's address and all of the information's down here. But if you go to the payment over here, if you scroll down, you see a Stripe Secure Payment Gateway. But if you don't have Stripe, you can use the cash on delivery, check payment, direct bank transfer, or you can even choose the PayPal options right here. But in my case, I'm going to show you how to set up for Stripe. We can click right here to manage. We can go to stripe.com, go to our dashboard. We can go to the developer mode right here. Click on API key, and we can copy the publishable key, the secret key right here, and go back to our website. If you scroll down, and you can go to the settings, and we can click right here to edit our keys. Okay, so I'm doing it in the test environment, so if you do it for real, you'll get paid when your product is sold. Okay, to fulfill these orders, all you have to do is just go over WooCommerce, order, and as you can see right here, I have a couple of orders, and this one I just ordered 3 minutes ago. You can click on this item right here to view the customer's information. As you can see right here, this is your customer's billing information and stuff like that, what products they buy. So if you sell a physical product, it's going to be the same thing. You can start shipping these products right here to your customers. But if you want to fulfill with AliExpress, you can go over here and click on this button right here, orders fulfillment, and we can choose the shipping company right here. We can click right here to fulfill this order. And as you can see right now, the Chrome extensions is doing all the work right now. It just opened a new tab where it enters all the customer's information on AliExpress. So when this is done, you can go to AliExpress and confirm the order. Okay, once it's done, it will show you the order's details, where you can check out the customer shipping address right here. You can enter your payment right here, and you can check out to see if this is the right products that orders on your website. So it's the right one. We can go over here, and we can, if you have a coupon code, you can enter this right here to save some money. So this product right here, we pay only $22, but we just sold it for $34. So we make about $15 for this items right here. Since you make a sale on your website, that means you already get paid, so you can make transactions over here and not going to lose any money for these transactions. Okay, we can go back to Ali2Woo. We can go to the imports list. As you can see right here, I have a bunch of different products. We can make the changes for these products. Okay, and then if you scroll up, we can click right here to all products. We can link it to a category. For example, it's going to be men fashion. Once we choose the category, we can click right here, and we can push all the products to our category. And just like that, the plugin is doing all the work right now. Okay, we can go back to the front end of the website. Sometimes it takes a few minutes for it to fully load on your website. So there are a lot of cool features for this website right here. So if you have any questions, feel free to contact me. Or if you want to build the website for your business, feel free to comment below. I'll put my information in the video descriptions. I want to thank you so much for watching. And please like and subscribe to support my channels. I really appreciate it. Thank you so much, and I'll see you in the next video. Peace.